George, I know you're about to do a lot of promotion this year for a young man called Jackie Lomax, and we heard a lot about him during the end of last year. Could he become the star of 69 that everybody's searching for? Is this your plan? Because at the moment it's all the old boys that are up there in the top 10.
Yeah, but the new boys fastly become old boys. Jackie's a new boy in as much as he's only really had one single release, but he's really an old boy. You know, he's been doing it since we started doing it in Liverpool. He was in a Liverpool band, and he's been through a lot of things. And I think it was in 1966, when we were doing our last tour of America, that we met Jackie. He'd been living a while in New York. And I felt a bit sad, you know. We were in our limousines and our big hotel suite, and we'd been through all that scene. And Jackie had been working, singing, since we first started, and yet he really hadn't got anywhere. I always thought he was pretty good. And I met him through the publishing. You know, he wanted to sell some songs. So I sort of verbally committed myself to produce a record by him. But unfortunately, you know, none of us here can manage him, because we're really a record company, not a managing agency or something.
Why haven't you opened a management division? Don't you think that would be a good idea for Apple?
It really would be, because when we set up the record company, we've been screwed a lot, you know.
Have you?
In business, we've been screwed. We've been given poor deals and things from different companies, you know, where...
You mean for yourself or
with
your
artists? For ourselves,
for
the Beatles, you know, over the last 7 years now. And I wanted to make sure that no artist was signed to Apple Records on a bum deal, you know, because obviously if the artist's happy, they're going to do the best. And if they're doing the best, it's going to be better for everybody. But if somebody's really not happy with the deal they've got, they're not, you know, it's just creates negativity. So
you seem to all come in and have a look and see what's going on and give instructions and keep a very close eye on what's going on,
yeah.
All four of you. Wouldn't it be a good idea if one of you decided to become the sort of figurehead of the company? Don't you think that would work?
That could work in one respect, but again, it wouldn't work in another. It's like, you know, we could have, say, just recorded my songs, make an album of my songs, or make an album of John's songs, or an album of Paul's songs. Now, maybe they're all going to be as valid as each other, but I think the most important thing about the Beatles was the separate personalities that made one whole, you know, because I wouldn't, if Paul was to run Apple, it'd start going in the direction I didn't really want it to go. And if John was running Apple, it'd be the same. And me,
yeah.
If I was left to run it, it'd end up with, you know, full of Indians and sitars and Jay Guru Dev.